Hello, right now I'm going to be reviewing the Nikkor 55-200mm f4-5.6 DX lens. Okay, so here's the lens itself. Right here is the HB37 lens hood that is supplied with the camera. This is the soft case that is supplied with the camera. This bottom part right here is hard, so it stands up straight. It closes with these two little ties. It's pretty much meant for if you don't have a case and you still want to protect your lens. So right here is the lens cap. The filter size on this lens is 52mm. Okay. So, this lens has manual focus and autofocus. There is a toggle switch for autofocus, then manual. This lens does have VR, which is short for vibration reduction. Right now I have it off. To turn it, you just switch this to on. Okay, so when you have this lens in manual, which it is right now, this little slider up here turns, and this is your focus ring. This focus ring is pretty sticky, which is nice when you're trying to achieve a good manual focus. It's not slippery at all, it doesn't skip or anything. And when it's in autofocus, it's pretty fast. I wouldn't say it's fast enough for like bird photography or nature photography in general, but it is good for some sports, maybe things like Not football, because the f-stop's too small. But probably for things like soccer and stuff like that, because those don't require lenses with a large f-stop. This lens, like I said, is f4-5.6. Those are the sharpest points. But I happen to believe that this lens is sharpest at f6. That's what it seems like when I'm using it on a D300. So, right now I'm at 55mm, and this is at 200. That's the maximum zoom range. The barrel does extend on this. And now if we go back to 55, it fits back in the lens. So now if you put the lens hood on, here's it at 55. Now I go back to 200. There's a length at 200. Now I'm going to show you what it looks like on a D300, then on a D60 with the battery grip. So first, here's a D300. Right here. To put this lens on, you're going to line up this white dot with that white dot. Put it on, and turn till it clicks. And your lens is now attached. Here it is on the D300. Doesn't add much weight and doesn't make the camera too long. This is a good walk-around lens because it's 55-200, which is a pretty good zoom range, because 55 is good enough for shooting people, and then you can go to 200 to shoot something that's requires a zoom. So now if we turn the camera on, right now I'm at f6.3. And since I'm at 55, I can stop it down to f4. But see, as I start to zoom in, the f-stop goes up. So right now, I'm at 200, and you can see the f-stop 5.6. Go back down to f4 when you're at 55. And when you're at 55, you can change it to f6. It's not like you're stuck at f4 when you're at 55. And when you're at when you're at 200mm, you're not stuck at f5.6. You can go all the way up to f22 if you want, or actually f32, which don't really know why you'd want to do that. And if you want to do some trails with lights in the daylight, that's pretty much all you probably use f32 for. There's probably actually a lot of other things, but can't think of any. Okay, so that was what it looks like on the D300. Now I'm gonna show you what it looks like with the D60 and the BG D10 battery grip. which is made by Targus and not Nikon, because Nikon, for some reason, doesn't want to make a better grip for their D60. I guess it's not considered a semi or camera that consumers would want a better grip. Okay, so here's a D60 with a better grip. You can see it's fairly large, but I mean, here's a D300 with no battery grip, but it's almost as large. So goes to show you the size of the D300. So let's take this lens cap off. And again, you're gonna line up the white dots, but there's a white dot right there. White dot right there. Same thing, just put on. Just turn to hear it click. So here it is with the D60. There is at 55. Now we'll go to 200. Back to 55. Without the lens hood, there's 55. And back 200. And the same thing does apply for this camera. Let's see right now. Let's bring this down all the way to F4. And if we start to zoom in, back at F5.6. Back at F4. So it goes with all cameras that you use with this lens. It's going to show F4 at 55 and F5.6 at 200 millimeters if you don't set the f-stop yourself. So now to talk about the sharpness of this lens. I would think this, I mean, this is a pretty sharp lens. At 55, that's when it's its sharpest. And at 200, the sharpest point is the center, like most lenses. And it does start to get a little bit out of focus and starts to warp the image a little bit at 200 millimeters. And that's only when you're using you're panning the camera really fast. But, I mean, I've shot some birds and stuff with this camera, some sports, and it's okay. But I try not to use this lens at 200 all the time. I'd strive for either 135 or even 105, because at 105, this is a fairly nice lens for the price. Especially because you're, at f4.6 at 105. And this does start to add weight with the D60, but not really when you have the D300, because you can't feel it because of the weight that the D300 has itself. That's why it's a nice walk-around lens for either this camera or the D300. And this does have a better grip, so it even adds more weight. VR does work pretty well at night. I would say it works best around sunset if you're going to try to do some low shutter speed. Like, I would say around 20th of a second, VR starts to not work anymore. I mean, it's really hard to stabilize stuff at 1/20th of a second. But at 1/60th, you can really see it, VR working. It does consume a lot of battery life, though, on both the D60 and D300. But I guess that's something you have to encounter when you're taking pictures with VR on. So that was my short review on the Nikkor 55-200mm f4 to 5.6 ED DX lens. And DX is meant for cameras that are not the D700, D3, D3S, or D3X, or in general, cameras that have a 35mm sensor, or in Nikon terms, cameras that have an FX sensor, which is the same size as 35mm film. So if you have one of those cameras, then this probably isn't the lens for you. You can still use it. It's not like it won't attach, or the camera will still recognize it and everything. It's just the characteristics of the camera won't be the same as using it on a DX lens, or a DX camera, sorry. So that was it for my review.